So we'll start recording. Take me to Luxon territory. Greetings, everyone. BJ Weiler, I'm back with you for day 17 of 100 days of gaming. Popping into Guild Wars here for a bit of PvP Fort Aspenwood action here on the continent of Kantha, which was part of Factions, the second campaign. This is sort of a special PvP map. It's like a PvPvE map, sort of. Let me do this. Enter battle so we can get into a mission here, hopefully. So this is held by a bunch of people pretty much every weekend, every Saturday and Sunday at 4 p.m. Eastern Time. The Galva people... Ooh, wow, that was good. We get a match right away. I was going to start talking about Extra Life. They get a match in. I think the only weekends that they don't do it is if there are Zacian missions for Alliance battles. We'll go over here. We'll get ready for our battle cry. So let's do our battle cry for glory, for honor, for bacon. Going in with my ranger again. I seem to do a little bit better with her for the time being. Maybe I'll pop into my elementalist at one point again. Boom. Tribe, I seem to have a little bit more luck with her right now. For travel, for fun, staller on wall. Ah, okay. So she does travel for fun, does what I do when I'm playing on the Kurzic side, is pop up on the wall inside one of the gates there. You bitch. Come on. All right. I spoke too soon. Now, what's our Zinray's? When you successfully, it is disabled for 3 seconds for all members of your party and the opposing party who are in the area and also have it on their skill bars. Wow, that's an interesting. Oh, you're killing me here. Absolutely killing me. Oh, let's send a turtle, why don't we? Yeah, send the purple squad to the battlefront. Dollar, yeah. I usually pop up on this side. They got good runners here on the Kurzik side, that's for sure.
What?
No, oh, we've been defeated. Huh? Okay. We'll give that a go again. In the meantime, let's see if we can get this Twitch app to work, because it didn't pick me up here. So I can't see the stream. Come on now. Ah, there we go. Oh, our volume. Excellent. Okay, good. So these matches are popped real quick there. So we got a lot of peeps here. Excellent. I wonder if I should... We'll go one more here and then we'll pop on my elementalist and see how that works. I think... how am I doing for Battle Thief action? Alright, after this match I'll have to remember to trade that in. Anyway, greetings everyone. BJ Walla here with you, and I need something here. I need to bump that up, please. Oh, there it is. I see it now. Excellent. So yes, this is Extra Life. We were playing for Extra Life. This is day 17 of 100 days of gaming. I'll be sure to check the description for this video, be it in the highlight, actually the highlight, or the video on YouTube as well, because this is going to be up on YouTube. You may already be watching this on YouTube. Thank you for watching. Thank you for watching this on Twitch as well, be it live or be it as the highlight or the past broadcast, which of course gets deleted after 2 weeks. So always check out the highlights. I preserve as much as I can of my live streams there with the highlights. But what is Extra Life, you ask? It's a way for us gamers to give back to our communities by basically doing what we're going to be doing anyway, what we enjoy doing, and that's playing games. So basically we sign up at extra-life.org. There's the website down here. To become participants. Being a participant is free at the classic level. And as I always say, you know, at the end of the day, the best part of this is being able to help the Children's Miracle Network hospitals and, of course, the kids that they treat. But by signing up, you do get some bling. I mean, it's you know, you do get a few digital goodies and other things, really. Throughout the course of the event, the main event, and your fundraising goals and that kind of stuff, meeting certain fundraising goals. So you do get a little something out of it besides, you know, the good feels and all that stuff. So essentially that's what it is. You know, we sign up to participate, we choose a hospital, we can join a team, we can play solo, we can join a guild. They're a little bit separate from teams. A guild is basically people local to your area playing for your same hospital that you choose to support. Whereas a team can be made up of anybody. And they usually are. So I am a member of the Philadelphia Guild. I am a member of Judgment Gaming, which is a couple of guys that's, you know, we were in the same Star Wars The Old Republic Guild for a while. So once we got involved with Extra Life, we decided to join or make a team, or our leader made a team, and I have joined. This my second year with Judgment Gaming. Oh, I forgot my battle cry. Well, we must not forget that. So for glory, for honor, for bacon cheeseburgers. Burgers on a pretzel bun. There we go. Okay, now that we got that out of the way, let's try to get this match. But that's what it is. So 100% of the money that we as gamers raise through people going to our participant page, mine is up there underneath my Extra Life goal, 100% of that money that is donated through our page, is given to the hospitals and is given to help sick kids get better. So we got that squared away. I missed that. Oh, we're doing a little bit better this match here, I should say. But that's what we're doing. We play games for kids. Our main event, our main 24-hour marathon, is November 5th and 6th this year. I will be starting my marathon the evening of Friday, November 4th. But what 100 Days of Gaming is just an opportunity for us to play and promote Extra Life even further. And it is exactly what it sounds like. It's 100 days of gaming. It's some of us Extra Lifers who've decided to take the challenge of playing a game for at least 1 hour every day for 100 days leading up to the marathon. So we got started July 8th, and we are almost 3 weeks into this now. So I'll be playing right up to November 4th and 5th. My body blocked? I guess I am body blocked here for something. Thank you. Alright, let's see if we can't take Juggy down here. Repair the gate now. Ooh. Ah, I didn't get it in time. Dang it. Didn't get my interrupt off in time. The green gate again. Ooh, man, we got a lot of monks here. Now, bless these guys, at least. That just leaves them for now. It's got Gunther down. Excellent, we got Gunther. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Alright, so we got a win under our belts there. Before I go into her, yes, but we go get ourselves a... here? I think this is where we go. No, I don't need to unlock heroes, I don't need to unlock skills, I don't need to unlock items, or do I? So I think I got almost everything pretty much unlocked at this point. Now this stuff you can unlock by identifying weapons you pick up as loot that are unidentified with these enhancements on them. So if it's an enhancement you don't know, like see Sundering Spearhead, I have not yet identified yet, neither have I identified a weapon with that on it. So everything else I've pretty much identified. Oh, there's a couple inscriptions I have not yet identified. How about that? Interesting. All right, so I need to get rid of some Balthy faction here. You're not going to give me what I need, are you? No. Oh, you know what? He's up here. Faction rewards. I think that might be it. Let's see. Nope, that's not it. Score 100 points in the Zos Chivalrous Channel. Yeah, I guess I should go for that. Imperial faction. That's what we're looking for. Okay. I'd like to make an exchange for Balthasar of action. No. Somebody I can trade in Balthasar of action for Nization Key. That's what I'm looking for. Ah, here we go. I should have guessed the first time. Buy a Nization Key with Balthasar faction. That's what we're looking for. Yes. There we go. Thank you. So now I've got two Zacian keys. Excellent. So we do own for Imperial faction. Oh, good. We're getting there. We're getting there. Oh, not going in yet. So, moral and extra life. So, I encourage everyone to participate. I encourage everyone to donate. Of course, naturally, because I want to see extra life succeed. So, what have we... let me see here. I think I've got what we raised last year. No, maybe I haven't. No, I don't have that handy, do I? I think I had that on another talk sheet. But, anyway, what's this money do that goes to the hospitals? Well, it goes to help fund research. It goes to, you know, buy equipment and upkeep, that kind of stuff, you know. And it goes probably, well, I guess they're all equally important, including this third one, which goes to help these hospitals with their funding, because they treat kids regardless of the family's ability to pay. So if they don't have insurance, or obviously, you know, with the insurance situation in the United States right now, you know, insurance barely covers the cost of a lot of these procedures and stuff like that. So it's very important, especially for kids. You know, they're coming in, they're going to these hospitals with cancer, with traumatic injuries, birth defects, serious illnesses, that kind of stuff. It's extremely important that they get the best treatment that they can. So these hospitals will do that regardless of the ability of the family to pay for whatever treatment is needed. So that's why Extra Life and the Children's Miracle Network fundraising opportunities are so important, because this is where the hospitals get the funds to cover all these costs and help them operate at a high efficiency and be able to do what they're there to do, and that's treat these kids to the best of their ability. So Extra Life is very important in that respect, that, you know, without what we're doing here for Extra Life, you know, the hospitals would be able to operate as well as they do now. Of course, Children's Miracle Network does all sorts of fundraising, and Extra Life is only a part of that. But, you know, last year, I believe, or to date, we have raised over $14 million. Since 2008, when Extra Life got started, over $14 million has been raised, and I think almost half of that, I think $6 million alone, was raised in 2015. So we're hoping to beat that number. It's gone up significantly year after year. 2 years ago, I think it was $4 million. You know, 3 years ago, it was $2 million raised. So actually, the word about Extra Life is getting out there. It's gaining the popularity. It's gaining the notoriety. So it's very important for everyone who can participate, and there's no reason why you really can't participate. It's really easy. You don't have to be a streamer. You don't have to play computer games. You don't have to play console games. You just have to be able to just sign up and just talk about it with friends and family. That's all I do. You know, and I'm already over halfway towards my initial, my starting goal here. Now, that goal is going to raise with the more money I do raise for my hospital, which is Children's Hospital of Philadelphia. So once I, you know, reach or get near or reach $200, I'm going to bump that up $25 or $50. I'm just going to keep fundraising and fundraising until the end of the year. Our fundraising starts January, ends December. So it goes for the full year, even though, you know, what we sort of hype up is this main event in November where we do play games for 24 straight hours. That's the big event, but the fundraising always goes on here. So I encourage everyone to participate, because it's a whole lot of fun at the end of the day. That's what it is, a whole lot of fun, and it's for one of the best causes out there, for a really great charity organization, and one where, you know, 100% of the money raised by what we're doing is going directly to the hospitals, directly to help these kids. And there's not a lot of charities and fundraising organizations that can claim that percentage honestly. Oh, still waiting for this to pop. But again, you know, if you are a streamer, however, or if you enjoy streaming or you're just getting started in streaming and stuff like that, you can even do more to help Extra Life, and that's become a member of the official Extra Life stream team. Now the stream team comprises all sorts of different guys. I mean, I'm a member of the stream team. We're all over the country, all over the place, and that's what we do. We stream on the official Extra Life channel. If you go up there and you see the Twitter Extra Life for Kids, or over that way, the Facebook Extra Life for Kids, that's the same thing on the Twitch, channel. They have their Twitch channel, which is Extra Life for Kids. And that's the channel we get to stream on. We get a two-hour block during the day. Right now, the days are Tuesdays through Sundays. The blocks start at 3 p.m. Eastern and run until 3 a.m. Eastern. So it's 3 to 5, 5 to 7, 7 to 9, 9 to 11, 11 to 1, and 1 to 3. So, and we're about halfway filled there right now. So, it's about a two-month commitment that we ask. For people to be able to set aside, that time to do their stream every week. I stream on Wednesdays, 9 to 11 p.m. Eastern time. It's a great lot of fun. It's a great thing to be involved with. It helps me learn how to be a better streamer, stuff like that, just by watching the other guys do it. So we do all sorts of fun things, not the least of which is talking about Extra Life while we're playing games. And I think one of the important things that I do like to mention as well for Extra Life is that, each gamer, when we sign up, we choose a hospital that we want to support. Naturally, it's going to, for the most part, it's one of our local hospitals. And there's hospitals all over Canada, United States, and we even have somebody, as a matter of fact, who just joined our stream team from Puerto Rico, and he's playing for a hospital down there. So, all across North America, we have these hospitals. But at the end of the day, the hospital that we're, of course, we're all competitive. We want our hospital to do really, really well. So we're always, competing with each other to see whose hospital can raise the most money and that kind of stuff. But at the end of the day, I always say this, it's that regardless of which particular hospital a gamer is supporting, it's always important to make a donation if you like what somebody is doing or you want to support them, regardless of what hospital that they're playing for, because at the end of the day, the money is going to help kids. So whether it's a kid in California or Canada or Puerto Rico or Pennsylvania or New Jersey, wherever these kids are, at the end of the day, it's going to help somebody's child get through a tough time. And that's the important thing. So, like I said, I'm a member of Judgment Gaming. So I always donate to my teammates. In fact, we just picked up a new teammate. I gotta donate to him. So we all play for different hospitals. So at the end of the day, I want to help support my teammates, help support their goals as they do help support mine. Regardless of which hospital we're playing for, at the end of the day, we're helping kids somewhere get better. Okay, for glory, for honor, for bacon. No, this will sound good. Bacon, for chocolate covered, for chocolate drizzled popcorn sprinkled with bacon flavored salt. There we go. Nom nom nom. Okay, well, that's good. We still have both with amber mines controlled here anyway, so let's pop one down here, see if we can't help out our turtle down here. Have a healer on the other side? Maybe, maybe not. Doesn't seem like it. Oh, I made it through. Oh, no, I didn't. I thought I made it through. There we go. Now I should be able to make it through. Nope, that went off a little bit too slow. Okay. He's got a healer. Where's that healer at? Interrupt off quick enough. Oh, I got it. That's Juggy here. Oh, we breached the green gate. Let's get in there, shall we? Dang it. Alright. Jeez, I'm a beast. Oh! We're gonna get Radic anyway. Some point here. Alright, looks like Radic went down. Yes. Okay, so we're in good shape now. Victory! Excellent. Alright, let's switch things up a bit. Let's head off to the other side. We'll talk to Shady Luxon and we'll go Kurzik. Should I swap? Nah, you know what? We'll stay here. I'll remember. I'll try to remember next time I do this. I'll do my elementalist. I just don't know how I'm going to top my last battle cry. While we're waiting, let's get some dancing in, shall we? My Zabinia Zerenth. Slash dance. Oop, that's not going to work. One E only, please. There we go. So what else can I say about Extra Life? I think I've pretty much covered all the bases. So anyway, I am BJ Weller, aka Real Millennium Group, playing 100 Days of Gaming. It is day 17. Getting a little bit of Fort Aspenwood PvP action going on in there. Bit for Extra Life. Again, you can follow Extra Life on the Facebooks, that way, on the Twitter. And of course on Twitch at Extra Life for Kids as well. Sign up to participate. Great fun. And don't think you have to, like I said, you don't have to be a streamer. You don't have to play computer games. People play board games. People play card games. People go out and play, you know, baseball in their backyard, stuff like that. Essentially, I mean, the only requirement really is that it has rules and you can play it. There you go. You can play baseball, soccer. Do it for 24 hours or not. If you can't do 24 hours, that's fine. If you can't do November 5th and 6th, that's fine. Do it when it's convenient for you. Do it when it fits within your schedule. The important thing is that, you know, you're participating and you're trying to raise money for whichever hospital you choose. That's really the important thing there. And of course, always talking about Extra Life, which is what we're doing here, which is why I am doing 100 Days of Gaming. Gives me an opportunity to do some live streaming, play games, which I do every day anyway. So might as well do it for a good cause, for Extra Life. And of course, I have my Extra Life playlist on the YouTubes. So I do have two Twitch channels here. This one, which I am currently streaming from, is my BJ Weiler channel. I also have my main... I guess they're both my main channels at this point. I also have my other channel, which is Real Millennium Group. So if you look at my participant page, just look at Real Millennium Group. That's my other Twitch channel. That one I've pretty much right now. In fact, this is why I started using the BJ Weiler channel. I had signed up for Twitch under BJ Weiler a while ago, but I was always using Real Millennium Group as my streaming channel. But for the last, just a little bit over a year now, almost a year and a half, I've actually been doing, what I call the Guild Wars Adventures on the Real Millennium Group channel. So I've pretty much stopped playing other games and doing other stuff on there except for the Guild Wars Adventures, on the Real Millennium Group channel. And basically that's what I'm doing. I started a brand new character. And I'm playing through each of the campaigns. Right now we're up for the 10th anniversary of each campaign. So Guild Wars came out in 2005, April 20, I think it was 29th when Prophecies, the first campaign, was released. 2005. So this, you know, April 2015, I decided, hey, let me do something, I guess, special for my own sake and sort of just to have some fun with Guild Wars again. And so I started a new character and played through the campaign, and we are almost done. And of course, the second campaign, which we are playing a little bit of here now, Factions, came out in April 2006. So we just started up that, the Canthan Adventures. The first one is the Tyrian Adventures, and this October will be the 10th anniversary of the third full campaign, Nightfall. which takes place on the continent of Alona. So we'll be starting up the Alonian adventures on my Real Millennium Group channel very shortly. For glory, for bacon. Oh, no, no, for glory, for honor. For, supreme pizza slathered in bacon. There we go. Oh, you know what I want to do? I want to do this. I forget when I'm Kurzik, I tried to do this a bit here. And I'm not on my Ella. Tried to be a staller here a little bit. Capture that race shrine. Where's Master Turtle? No, we got somebody down here, huh? Oh, whoa, whoa, that was fast. Who the heck is down here? Oh, Tricky Moon alone in the screen. Okay. Shoot, I gotta get up here. They're already in the gates. That didn't work out as planned. Usually I try to keep that shrine from here, but obviously with the Loxons in here, that's not going to quite work so well. I guess the best bet here now is just going to be to run Amber. See if I can't just get this shrine capped anyway. That didn't work out so well. Oh, he's gonna die anyway. Boop, boop. Way. here. Oh no, they're in anyway. Oh, we're about to lose. Oh no. All right, we'll get one more match underway here. And we'll call this day 17 concluded. Maybe I should pop into my Ella here. We'll see if this match pops. If not, we'll pop over real quick. Yep, all right, we popped then. Never mind. I actually didn't expect it to pop that quick. For glory, for honor, for bacon wrapped. Bacon dipped in bacon grease. Grease and drizzled and sprinkled with bacon flavored salt. Ah, there we go. Follow me, people. Follow me. Thank you. Dude. See if we can't kill this damn turtle. Get a shot off at least. There we go. Couple of shots. So you've got monkeys there, so that doesn't help. Monkey, monkey, monkey. The healing monk. This is where my Ella would probably come in a lot more handier. At some point we get somebody. Alright, let's just run Amber then. Let's go this way. Since things are starting to look a little hairy here. This would be a little bit tricky. Oh, Ugh. At least I got a teammate to pick up the chunks. Oh good, we got somebody capping the points, so that helps. Let's see if we can't get this, this is where my Ella would really be handy, because she's better equipped for I'm dead. Ugh. She's better equipped to take out these guys. Alright, so let's defend the home base here, shall we? Got him. Actually got a couple of interrupts in there. I am shocked beyond all comprehension. Oh, defeated. Defeated. Alright, that's good. That's good. That's good. It's time to go eat some bacon, I think. I'm all hungries now. All hungries. So thank you one and all for checking out a little bit of Fort Aspen PvP action here in Guild Wars for day 17 of 100 days of gaming. Once again, I am BJ Weller, aka Real Millennium Group. Be sure to check out my participant page. Be sure to check out my YouTube channel, Real Millennium Group. And be sure to check out both my Twitch channels, BJ Weller and Real Millennium Group. And of course, be sure to check out the Extra Life for Kids Twitch channel as well. Check out all the streamers we've got on the official Extra Life stream team. Lots of good fun, lots of different games, lots of different activities going on. We even got a guy who does little miniatures and stuff like that he makes himself, so that's pretty awesome. But at the end of the day, it's all for a good cause. It's for Extra Life. It's us gamers being real-life heroes for these hospitals and for the kids that they treat. Then that's really the most important thing. So sign up. And donate too, as well. Till next time, I will see you in game.